Hey there, my retro addicted community. I thought I'd bring you an episode right from my holidays. You've seen this Sun Fire V120 before, back when we explored this Sun RAID terminals. I already demonstrated the versatility of Solaris when we looked into WABI, the Windows application binary interface, which allowed you to run Windows applications natively on the Solaris desktop. And of course, there was SunPCi, a full-blown PC on a PCI card running right inside your SPARC workstation. But there was another way. Thanks to Insignia SoftPC and SoftWindows, Solaris gained the ability to run DOS and Windows entirely in software inside a virtual PC long before the reign of VMware. I love old computers. I love to collect them. I love to fix them. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my stories. This isn't the first time we see soft Windows in this channel, and definitely also not the last time. Long before VMware and Virtual PC, a company named Insignia Solutions had already solved the problem. Founded in 1986 by former CAD/CAM engineers in Mountain View, California, Insignia originally aimed to be a consultancy. But a side project called SoftPC quickly emerged to become their main product, a software-based x86 emulator allowing Unix workstations to run DOS applications without any Intel hardware. Later, Insignia introduced SoftWindows, bundling full copies of Windows 3.x or Windows 95 into the emulated environment. It supported Solaris, Irix, NextStep, macOS, and more, bringing PC compatibility to platforms that otherwise had none. By the mid-90s, Insignia dominated this niche until Kinectix and Virtual PC arrived, which led to their decline. But for a while, SoftPC was the only way to run PC software on a Unix workstation or on a Macintosh. I previously featured SoftWindows and SGI Irix and had always wanted to look at the Solaris version. But I held off, mostly because of licensing concerns, especially after reading this comment here. Spoiler, at least for version 2.0, this was totally unnecessary, as we'll see in a minute. That said, I downloaded a copy of SoftWindows 2.0 and loaded it up to that Sun Fire V120. You may ask why. I was looking for a way how to make PC emulation available to Sun RAID terminal users. Although it's perfectly possible to share the Sun PCI, it's constrained to a single session, so only one user may access it at a time. So I fired up swinst, which offered me to install different language options, customization of the included packages, and finally the system keyboard type. At one point, it asked me for the X11 display, obviously not detecting it as I ran all this through a SunRay session. I hacked in 2.0 as that was my virtual display ID, but that was obviously not sufficient as I ran it from inside a root shell, whereas the terminus session was owned by my unprivileged account. But firing it up manually did something, and if only popping up that error message about the missing license. But where do I get it? My research brought me to this website here, which had some license files and even this compressed archive here. Weirdly enough, this one contained excerpts from my own blog I wrote 16 years ago. So in a weird twist of fate, I became my own answer to where to obtain the license key. And believe it or not, dumping that license information to /opt/softwindows2/flexlm/license.dat just made it work. That said, FLEXlm was obviously the same across all platforms. However, when starting, SoftWindows would complain that it needs a changeable 256 colors bitmap, likely due to a compatibility issue with the Sun RAID terminal software. In this setup, it ran only in black and white mode. The configurative options for 4-bit and 8-bit color mode remained without function in this scenario. At least, SoftWindows uses its own configuration file inside your home directory, so you could run it concurrently, only limited by the processing power and free RAM available. You can select different screen resolutions, but again, black and white is limiting. And unfortunately, even the user's guide wasn't much help on this topic. Then again, SoftWindows was also available for Next Step and Next Stations, and those were initially available on grayscale displays only. So maybe, running SoftWindows in monochrome mode isn't such a big deal. After all, monochrome Windows is still better than no Windows at all, right? And as you may have guessed already, the Next Stations ran on Motorola 68K CPUs, the same architecture as classic Macintosh systems. So next time, we'll take a look at SoftPC and SoftWindows on the Mac before heading into the origins of Apple Unix. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching and see you again next Sunday.